Bollywood has been churning out a lot of patriotic movies lately. It seems like all you need to do for box office success is to put any patriotic topic on the plate, sprinkle in some songs, and preferably serve with the side of Akshay Kumar. We at Muncher Movies want to dig deep and figure out the best patriotic movies to come out of Bollywood. While we're not lucky enough to have seen every Bollywood movie ever made, we've seen quite a few from the last few decades, so our list is slightly weighted towards modern Bollywood. And patriotism can mean many things to many people, of course, so our choices reflect our interpretation. To some, Sunny Deol wrecking people with a hand pump in Gadar might be the most patriotic thing ever, and to others, it might be calling yourself Mr. India to take on Mogambo. So if you disagree with us, definitely let us know what you think we missed out on in the comments, and let us know why. In the meanwhile, let's jump right into our very first category. Our first category is sports. While it is a thriving genre in the West, Indian sports movies these days often veer towards biopics. Of course, it isn't necessary that a sports movie even be patriotic. The cycle race at the end of Jo Jeeta Woh Sikandar has no impact on India. On the other hand, the final match of CHAK the India, our first honourable mention in this category, is incredibly high stakes, linking Shah Rukh Khan's character reputation arc to the Indian women hockey team winning the World Cup. In what is often regarded as one of Shah Rukh's best performances, CHAK the India's ensemble cast of women from all over the country, many of whom were hockey players and not actors, symbolises unity and diversity, something India is known for and sports are ideal for fostering. While many films since then have tried to capture the inherent drama real sporting stories provide and convert it into movie magic, such as Reema Kakti's Gold, about our first gold medal as an independent nation, most of the best films in this genre rely on additional dramatic elements, whether real or fictional, to weave into the story and give it emotional stakes. Think Milkha Singh's tragic backstory, where he was orphaned during the partition and suffered PTSD. Marie Kom's dilemma about choosing boxing over family. And Dangal's nuanced father-daughter dynamics. Again, these were all true stories with the dramatic portions enhanced or created from scratch. However, our top pick has to go to a completely fictional tale that absolutely captured the hearts of the nation in 2001, Lagaan. Inspired by Naya Daur starring Dilip Kumar, which we want to talk about further down the list, Lagaan became the third Indian film to get an Oscar nomination, and for good reason. We've all seen it, right? And if you're watching this video and somehow missed it, go watch it right now. It holds up in every way. The casting, acting, production, music, storytelling are all on point. On paper, the story of villagers in the British Raj learning cricket to take on the powers that be and avoid taxes sounds ludicrous. Add in a somehow convincingly portrayed love triangle between Aamir Khan's Bhuvan, Gracie Singh's Gauri, and the English actress Rachel Shelley, and you start to wonder who was audacious enough to even attempt telling such a unique story. The answer is a young Ashutosh Gavarikar, who secured an at the time unprecedented budget of 25 crores with the help of first-time producer Aamir Khan himself. The fact that the good guys win in the end is a trope found in almost every sports movie, but watching Kachra and Bhuvan at the crease was something truly special. Our next category is freedom fighters. Plenty of Bollywood movies have paid tribute to the men and women who secured the country its independence, of course. And many have made sure that we don't forget those who dared to raise their voices or their swords against tyranny along the way. 2019's Mani Kannika, for instance, starring and co-directed by Kangana Ranaut herself, was based on the life of Rani Lakshmibai, one of the leading figures in the rebellion of 1857. Another key figure was Mangal Pandey, and when Aamir Khan took a three-year hiatus to focus on making Mangal Pandey the Rising, expectations were high, but ultimately the movie fizzled away from our minds. Even though it's not technically a pure Bollywood movie, an honourable mention is surely Richard Attenborough's Gandhi, an epic historical drama covering the life of the father of the nation, played by Sir Ben Kingsley. It's hard to say how that casting choice would go down with today's woke Indian audiences. Ben Kingsley is half Indian, but he was actually praised in spades for his performance. Shyam Benegal's biopic, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, aimed to strike a tone in line with the man it was portraying and was unapologetically 3.5 hours, almost as if it was a tribute to Gandhi's 3-hour-plus runtime. Another favourite in this category is actually Rajkumar Santoshi's The Legend of Bhagat Singh, starring Ajay Devgan as Bhagat Singh. It managed to strike the perfect balance between emotional stakes, the urge for revolution that Bhagat Singh was famous for, and even comedy. with plenty of comedic scenes courtesy the director of the cult classics of all cult classics, Andaz Apna Apna. However, these films tend to be straightforward stories, focusing on one revolutionary at a time and tracing their life in the context of India's freedom struggle. They do not even come close to the nuance, ambition, and masterful execution of our pick in this category, Rakesh Omprakash Mehra's Rang De Basanti. If you think we are starting to favor Aamir Khan, think again, because Rang De Basanti is hardly an Aamir Khan movie. It's an ensemble drama that captured the latent revolutionary spirit in the youth of its time so perfectly, the protests and candlelight vigils shown at the end of the movie actually became commonplace in the real world after its release. Written and helmed by a director who had failed commercially with his debut 5 years earlier, the film somehow found backers based on its genius script and was anchored by an inspired Aamir performance, whose character DJ was complemented beautifully by the Hindi-speaking British documentary filmmaker Sue, played by Alice Patton. Rang De Basanti became an instant cultural phenomenon upon release, and it's easy to see why. The story beautifully melded freedom fighters, modern-day politics, patriotism, and how the youth of 2006 wrestled with it all, sometimes literally. Moving on, we want to take a look at a very popular movie genre, the spy thriller. The patriotic version of this tends to revolve around our intelligence agencies, such as RAW, CBI, and others. In Bollywood, this genre evolved from showing straightforward stories demonstrating the competence of our agencies, such as 16 December, which had all the polish of its Hollywood counterparts, and the more recent Baby, Neeraj Pandey's slick story about a task force that was formed in response to the 2008 Mumbai attacks. And speaking of Neeraj Pandey, we must mention his directorial debut, A Wednesday, which paired Nasiruddin Shah and Anupam Kher in a unique spin on the cops and robbers chase and showed a totally different angle on terrorism and the angst of the common man. Meanwhile, Akshay Kumar and John Abraham are mocked in recent times for leaning too much on patriotism in their output. But we're not complaining, since their films Airlift and Parmanu were both compelling portrayals of true stories. Airlift detailed the evacuation of 1.7 lakh Indians from Kuwait, an amazing achievement during a politically tenuous time, and the deft execution of its story, coupled with a now-expected solid performance by Akshay Kumar, really struck a chord with audiences, giving it a box office run usually reserved for Khan-driven entertainers. Parmanu, the story of Pokhran, captured the drama of India's nuclear test. And while it was criticized for tugging on our patriotic heartstrings without subtlety, it was a dramatized depiction of a moment in our history that otherwise may have gone unnoticed by the masses, and for that it deserves its due. A special mention here can even go to Tiger Zinda Hai, starring Salman Khan and Katrina Kaif, which was loosely based on the rescue of 46 Indian nurses held captive in Iraq in 2014. We can only assume that it was this real-world connection that helped the film make over 500 crores, and not Salman Bhai and Katrina Behan. However, at the risk of being biased once again towards more recent films, our top pick here is 2018's RAAZI, directed by Meghna Gulzar and starring Alia Bhatt. Once again based on an incredible true story, RAAZI details how an Indian woman secret agent married a Pakistani army officer to provide RAW with confidential information prior to the Indo-Pak War of 1971. The premise is ripe for a lot of tension-filled moments, which the movie does predictably provide. But what separates it from the rest in the spy thriller genre is precisely how the protagonist lacks the slick and polish we would expect. Sent into enemy territory after a brutally short training period, she must survive only using her wits and her courage, constantly risking her life in the service of her mission. If you thought moral dilemmas faced by undercover cops in mobster movies are hard, imagine having to murder your brother-in-law and eventually cause the death of the innocent husband you had grown fond of just for your country. Alia Bhatt portrayed a young girl who ultimately was willing to do whatever it takes. And isn't that what true patriotism is all about? Up next, we have a category we created ourselves, which is to say that it is not a traditional film genre. We're calling it Yeh Mera India, and it refers to films that represent the diversity of experiences that make up our unique country. This doesn't mean that they assert that the country itself is perfect or necessarily insinuate that it isn't. Rather, they recognize India as a young, developing nation that's constantly evolving, and as long as it continues to do that, we will always be leaving it better than we found it. By capturing the essence of its time, certain classics like Mother India and Naya Daur represent India in all its glory, beauty, and sometimes tragedy. However, over the past few years, modern Bollywood has been perfecting how to package social issues as entertainment, and this has yielded some brilliant, important, patriotic films. to begin with, Toilet, Ek Prem Katha and Batman, both starring Akshay Kumar and produced by him, are brilliant movies that tackle taboo issues prevalent across villages and small towns in India. Between the two, Toilet seems the more patriotic to us. It is a satirical comedy dealing with the issues of open defecation and improvement of sanitation conditions in rural India, with an important focus on the underrated plight of women and the conservative religious sentiments at the root of the problem. The film was a massive box office success, making over 300 crores, an unimaginable feat for a social awareness-oriented film in the past, and a good sign for things to come. Other honorable mentions include Bhavesh Joshi's Superhero, a vigilante action film that flew under the radar despite being directed by Vikramaditya Motwane and co-written by Anurag Kashyap. It starts off with a group of passionate friends creating a YouTube channel, Insaf TV, as their attempt to clean up the society they live in. And as the story continues, it becomes more and more about one man's decision to not escape India as he was originally intending to, and instead create the change he wants to see in the world around him. His MO just happens to include a really funky paper bag mask over his face. But as much as we love the recent trend of social awareness and using genres such as comedy and action to get an important message across to a mainstream audience, we believe the clear objective winner in this category, and we do mean objective because for once we made up the category, is Swades. Even haters of Shah Rukh Khan's chocolate boy persona of the time could not deny how his performance in this beautiful film touched the hearts of the nation. A simple tale of an NRI returning to his homeland. Ashutosh Gawarikar, with his second entry on our list, wrote, directed and produced the movie and decided to go in the opposite direction from the high concept premise and the good guys versus bad guys finale of Lagaan. Swades is slow, deliberate, realistic and evokes emotions through empathy and nostalgia instead of contrivances. Mohan, the protagonist, visits India for a few weeks and ends up in a village in UP. He realizes what his home and his country mean to him and finds love, not just the romantic kind, but love for his motherland. Thanks to the A.R. Rahman music that immortalized its title track and the phrase "Ye jo desh hai tera, Swades hai tera," we have to wipe away the tears from our eyes as we declare Swades the clear winner in this category. Our final category is war and military movies. Usually the most impactful patriotic stories in this genre are based on real battles, since they carry the emotional weight of our history. 2019's Kesari depicted one such battle between 21 Sikh soldiers and thousands of Afghani tribesmen, and it showcased the potential of the human spirit when faced with insurmountable odds and high stakes. Another recent outing by Bollywood was Uri, Aditya Dhar's confident directorial debut, starring Vicky Kaushal, that comes out guns blazing, literally. It performed exceedingly well at the box office and became a fitting tribute to the Indian Army, modernizing Indian war movies with gritty action sequences and an incredible performance by Kaushal. There was a time when war movies in Bollywood were reliably multi-starters. For instance, 2003's LOC Kargil, an over 4-hour long epic, features an ensemble cast of over 10 well-known actors and is based on Operation Vijay around the line of control during Kargil. This allows us to get different perspectives from each character and capture the diversity inherent in our troops. Films like LOC Kargil make it impossible to not marvel at the patriotism and bravery of those in our armed forces, and we want to take this opportunity to salute them and thank them for their service. Many films try to capture the mind of the soldiers in our armed forces as a way for us to care about the characters, but none has done it better than Farhan Akhtar's Lakshya. He decided to tell the coming-of-age story of an aimless young man as he develops into a competent army officer, set against the backdrop of the 1999 Kargil war once again. Many call this Hrithik Roshan's finest hour and the best performance of his career, and we may just agree. However, we feel like we beat around the bush long enough and there is actually no real competition when it comes to this category. You may have already guessed it, the winner is Border. Inspired by real-life events during one of the first engagements in the 1971 Indo-Pak War, when 120 Indian soldiers faced over 2,000 Pakistani soldiers and dozens of tanks, Border manages to incorporate all the key elements of our honorable mentions and churn out something way better than the sum of its parts. Insurmountable odds? Check. Ensemble cast? Check. Every character, actor and on-screen soldier manages to leave their mark. Emotional backstories? Check. The song Sandesh Se Aate Hain became a patriotic anthem for the families of Jawans. Where movies often struggle between choosing to glorify war or condemn it, Border deals with the reality of war and instead glorifies its characters, soldiers sacrificing their lives in the harsh desert to hold the border, showing us what maybe we are all capable of when fighting for a cause we truly believe in, our country. And that is why Border remains the best patriotic movie ever made in Bollywood and, as far as we are concerned, in the world. That wraps up our list. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to let us know any films we missed out on.